Right, when it comes to time zones, there's basically two types of calculations. The first type is what I call the direct calculation. Okay, and that type of calculation is when they tell you, for instance, it is 10 o'clock the morning in Cape Town. Okay, what time is it in Perth? Okay, where you have to calculate the direct time. When it's 10 o'clock in Cape Town, what time is it in Perth at that very moment? That is the first type of calculation. The second type of calculation is where they include flying time for you. So you might get a calculation that reads, a businessman depart from OR Tambo. Obviously, you know OR Tambo is in Johannesburg, right? So a businessman departs from OR Tambo on the 1st of January at 11 o'clock in the morning. Okay, he flies to New York. Okay, and his flight was a 15-hour flight. So what time did he arrive in New York? That is the second type of calculation that they might give you. Okay, now we're going to in subsequent videos, we're going to have a look at both of those type of calculations, but you don't have to worry. To calculate both of those type of calculations is actually very easy. All you need to know for now is that the first type of calculation is what I call a direct calculation, and the second type of calculation is the calculation where there's flying time involved. But I will explain both of that type of calculations in subsequent videos. Another very important thing that you need to know is how do you calculate time zone difference. Now, time zone difference is very important to be able to calculate the time zone difference. Let's take this first type of calculation where they tell you you have to calculate the difference in time between Cape Town and another place, and this place is Perth, right? Now we know Cape Town is +2, Perth is +8. So what is the time zone difference between these two? That this is one time zone, that's another time zone. This is a time zone, that's another time zone. What is the difference in time between these two time zones? Now there's a very easy way to calculate it. But first of all, let me ask you quickly. That sign that I'm making right here, that's obviously a plus sign, right? And this sign right there is obviously what we call in maths the minus sign. I'm going to teach you a trick now how to figure out when you have to add these times. Like, do I have to add the 2 plus the 8, or do I have to subtract the 2 from the 8? Okay, that is normally the difficult part. Now I'm going to teach you a trick. It all starts with a Greenwich meridian. Now let's draw this Greenwich meridian. You can draw the meridian anywhere on a scrap piece of paper. What the next thing that you need to do is, in the calculation that they're going to give you, there's always two places. In this case, it was Cape Town, and the other place was Perth. Now we know that Cape Town and Perth is both on the same side of the Greenwich meridian. So what you do here is you draw two dots. The first dot represents the first city, the second dot represents the second city, and all you do is to connect the dots. And then you ask yourself, what mathematical sign do I see there? Is that a plus or is that a minus? Obviously, that is a minus. So the rule is, if the two cities that I'm calculating is both on the same side of the Greenwich meridian, I just draw two dots, connect the two dots, and that sign will tell me what I have to do with this. So in this case, the two cities is +2 for Cape Town and +8 for Perth. So, but that is the minus sign, so I have to minus the 2 from the 8. And then my time zone difference would be 6 hours. Let's take another calculation or another example where, in this case, let's say they tell you the two cities in your calculation is, for instance, Cape Town. Now, on which side of this Greenwich meridian is Cape Town? Cape Town is obviously on the eastern side of the Greenwich meridian. Now let's just make a little dot there for Cape Town. And then the other city that we're going to calculate is New York. Now, New York, we know, is on the western side of the Greenwich Meridian. Now, let's just make another dot here. Because right now, we're only concerned about the relation of the two cities in relation to the Greenwich Meridian. So this would be Cape Town in this case, and that would be New York on the western side of the Greenwich Meridian. Now, like what we did here with Cape Town and Perth, we just connect these two dots, and what do we see there? What sign is that here, right here? That is a plus sign. Okay, so what we need to do, Cape Town we know is plus 2 and New York is minus 5. So, but that sign here tells us we have to add the two together. The 2 plus the 5 will give us a 7-hour time zone difference. See the rule? If the two cities that you are working with is on opposite sides of the Greenwich Meridian, then you just do the two dots like I did here, connect the dots, and if it intersects with the Greenwich Meridian, it will form a plus sign there, and that plus sign will be your tip to tell you that you have to add the two numbers together. Don't worry about the plus sign or the minus sign in front of the numbers, just add the numbers together. Okay, another example, for instance, let's say the two places that you need to calculate would be New York and California. Now let's just do another. Let's say that is New York. Now you know New York is on the west side of the Greenwich Meridian, and California is on the western side of the Greenwich Meridian. So that would be California, right? And if you connect the two, what sign is that? Minus, right? So you have to minus the two time zones from each other to get the time zone difference. Very easy. If you don't understand it the first time you watch this video, I suggest to you just watch it again. So that's it for now. We'll catch up again in subsequent videos. Thank you.